searching for the good in our neighborhoods and each other. Not just finding what's wrong, but what's right. A true reflection of Cincinnati. Find the good in your mornings. Good morning, Tri-State.
This is WCPO 9 News.
We want to thank you for choosing us. I'm Evan Millward. Here's a look at some of today's top stories. An 8-year-old has died after a Mount Airy shooting. This happened this afternoon on Hawaiian Terrace. Cincinnati police say its criminal investigation section was called out to that scene. The homicide unit's now handling the investigation. We're still working to learn what happened leading up to this shooting. An accused serial Cincinnati rapist is in jail now, charged with more than a dozen crimes dating back to the mid-90s. 62-year-old Stoney Brown faces 19 counts of rape, kidnapping, and aggravated burglary. Hamilton County Prosecutor Joe Dieters tells me today that they tracked down Brown using genealogy sites and his DNA. In fact, they indicted his DNA profile in 2008 as a John Doe because they just didn't know who they were looking for then. Technology's come a long way. Police arrested Brown yesterday. Now his DNA is going into a national database to see if it matches any other unsolved crimes. The UC community tonight is mourning the loss of a legend. Family members and friends are remembering the life of University of Cincinnati basketball star and coach Tony Yates. Yates died Saturday night at the age of 82. The Lawrenceburg native helped lead the Bearcats to a pair of NCAA national championships in 61 and 62, then returned to his alma mater as the team's head coach from 1984 to 1989. Yates will be inducted into the Ohio Basketball Hall of Fame on June 6th in Columbus. Meanwhile, the other big story today is the rain and Raven. It's going to be the big story for the next couple of days, too.
Yes, it is, because you know what? Starting at 8 a.m. on Monday all the way to 8 p.m. on Tuesday, we are looking at a flash flood watch for everybody in the tri-state. So with this, we are talking about the possibility of having 2 to 3 inches of rain. Some areas could see some localized flooding. So as we head into the early morning hours of Monday, you can see very scattered activity. But then we do see a little bit of a break as we head to about 6. Some places will see some spotty showers, and this trend just continues on as we head towards Monday afternoon. And this rain does not completely leave until we make it to about Wednesday. So we got a couple of days of some rain. Big story there will be that flash flood watch. Here's a look at the next several days after that. We remain into the 60s. And then if you look all the way to the weekend, we start to see a warm up and temperatures are looking good as well.